My dear engineering college, principal, HOD, and professors, today I am writing this letter on behalf of all engineering students. I am not going to complain about why we are not getting jobs and why many engineers have to switch their career while looking for a job and why some students drop out in halfway. And even after 4 years of hard work, only 8% of engineers are eligible to get a job. But why? What are the reasons for this pitiful situation of engineering colleges? Faculty members. First and most important factor. Here most of the professors teaching us are the degree holders who fail to figure out what to do with their degree. They are actually not passionate about teaching. Just last year, 2 graduates become assistant professor in main subject of mechanical branch. So I asked him, why don't you search for better job because they won't pay you much to be assistant professor? And I freaked out on what he replied. Bhai, I have already wasted 1 year searching for job. Ab jo mila wahi sahi hai. So let me get this straight. The engineers who fail to get job anywhere are becoming teachers. So how can we expect good teaching from them? So let's see how universities around the world are making education more interactive.
We have lecturers with sometimes great and sometimes average qualities standing in front of a class of students trying to transfer their knowledge into their minds. Following what I said before, that mode of education is not really the best use of anybody's time. For example, Stanford University, that is teaching a course that actually goes back to the 60s and 70s, where industry partners give students problems and students have to work on these problems and come up with solutions. What you see here on this screen is a typical classroom session, where you see the 2 professors, actually 3 of them, sitting there, working with the students in a highly engaged manner over many, many months to really understand the problems and design solutions.
Another thing I want to mention is education does not match with the industry. Syllabus of most engineering branches are outdated. And while looking at industry, new technologies are changing things way faster than you think. The rise of artificial intelligence, blockchain, robotics, automation are going to disrupt all industries. So one day I went to computer science and IT department and took survey of 100 students of 3rd and 4th year. I asked 2 questions. What is artificial intelligence and what is blockchain? Not even 10 students were able to explain what is the meaning of these 2 terms. If you don't update your courses, your engineers will get behind, and if your engineers will get behind, it is failure of our education system. Last thing I want to mention is your approach to studies. You focus more on CGPA than passion and interest of that student. You focus more on writing assignments and lab manuals than doing actual practical in lab. You focus more on attendance than attention. You have always encouraged students to mug up and get marks rather than explaining fundamental of that subject. Because you only care about how much return on investment you make, completely ignoring how much time and money that student and his family have invested. So what is the conclusion of this story? Even after studying 4 years and spending big amount of money on college, only 18% of engineers get job in their core sector. Because colleges have become businesses, you only care about how much money you can pull out from students' pocket. while stealing most important time of that student's life and leaving them alone after your selfish purpose get accomplished. But now enough of this. We are going to take control of our boats. Just wait and watch.